thank you for attending our annual Christmas concert. We hope you enjoyed the show. Thank you again, and good night.
Another great performance, Vicky. I don't know how you do it.
Yes, thank you so much for your time. The children were wonderful.
Thank you. I love what I do.
Can we help you clean up?
Oh, the kids and I will take care of everything. I'll run the home a little later if that's okay.
Sure thing. See you later, kids.
Bye.
Phew. Another Christmas concert in the books. Children, that was another fabulous Christmas performance. You were all just marvelous.
Everyone but me.
I did notice you wise men were a little late with your entrance. What seems to be the problem, Nick?
I caught my sandal in the robe, Mrs. Toon.
Don't worry, Nick. You were great. And you too, Madison.
Thanks, Mrs. Toon. I loved my costume. The wings are awesome.
Mrs. Toon, how did Zach and I do as Mary and Joseph?
Just fine. But I did wonder, why did you sit on opposite sides of the stage?
I have a firm policy of affection, Mrs. Toon. In other words, no hand-holding. I can deal with close, but definitely no physical contact.
Oh, brother, we weren't supposed to hold hands, just stand by each other. But I am with you on the hand-holding. Last year, I had to hold Michael's hand in the finale, and he had just eaten cheese curls, and I was a sheep. He got orange cheese stains all over my paws.
Well, the performance is almost perfect. There was just one major problem.
Okay, why is everyone looking at me?
You kept crowding everyone and moving to the front. We were all angels, Brittany.
I guess you can say that. But of course, I was the lead angel. You will obviously work for me.
I don't think so.
Remember, Brittany, all angels are created equal.
I should have been Mary. That would have fit my personnel much, much better.
Why, Brittany, I think you made a wonderful angel. Remember, children, Jesus is the reason we have Christmas. This program wasn't about us. It was a gift to Jesus for the joy he brought on that wonderful night. I just want to make that message clear. Oh my, is that my phone? Hello? Yes? Oh my. Oh my. I'll be right there. Goodbye, dear. Oh dear, oh dear, whatever shall I do?
What seems to be the problem, Mrs. Toon?
That was my niece. My Aunt June fell and broke her hip. And they're on their way to the hospital and I need to meet with them immediately. But who will tend you children and put away all the sets and get ready for Sunday services?
We'll do it, Mrs. Toon.
Sure thing. We can dig down the decorations.
Well, if you're sure. The church custodian, Mr. T, is in the building and will be here shortly to help. So you will not be alone. I'll make sure to contact him on my way out of the church.
Don't worry, Mrs. Toon. We'll have all this put away in no time.
Sure thing. Go and see if I aunt. We got this under control.
Okay then, I'm off. Thank you, children. After I check on Aunt June, I'll make sure to give you all rides home.
Goodbye, Mrs.
See you later.
Bye.
See you later. Safe travels.
Come on, everybody. Let's get busy. Joey and I will start taking down the Christmas tree. Madison, you and Zach are putting away the bells. Laura, you and Brittany start gathering out the presents. If we all work hard,
we'll have this put away in no time. I'm tired. I want to go home.
Come on, Brittany. Mrs. Toon has been great. We owe it to her and the church.
Makes me wonder why we do this Christmas musical every year. It's tons of work. And now, we don't have to clean up after ourselves. I think it'd just be wonderful if we skip this whole major thing and went right to the presents. I want to get home and open my iPhone X.
What a terrible thing to say.
Sometimes, Brittany, you can be so annoying.
Come on, just get started.
Get your mind off those presents and get to work.
I can't help it. I just can't wait. I want my presents.
Brittany, please stop.
Yes, you are definitely getting on my last nerve.
Me too. And if we don't get busy, we'll be here all night.
Well, I'll let you guys finish. I'm going to take a nap.
Can I help you?
Are you Mr. T? Mrs. Toon said you'd be coming by.
Well, my friends call me Terrence.
Glad to meet you, Terrence.
I suppose you heard Mrs. Toon has gone to the hospital. Her Aunt June fell and broke her hip.
Yes, I heard about that.
Well, we just started putting things away.
We're just having a little trouble with Brittany.
Brittany?
That's me.
So I've heard that you wanted to skip the whole Christmas story idea.
Well, yes. How did you know that? How could he help but hear?
My boss hears and knows everything, and he keeps me informed.
Must be what those new surveillance systems are putting in everywhere. I guess all this manger stuff is okay, but I'm really ready for presents. And here I am, stuck, putting away decorations.
Brittany, you need to stop talking. You are not making sense. There's no Christmas without Jesus. Don't you remember what Mrs. Toon said?
Well, I'm just thinking presents. I can't help it. My mind is on the finer things in life.
You can't mean what you're saying.
Christmas would be terrible without Jesus. Just think.
Shepherds in a field nearby, no
Major Bethlehem stuff and get down to business. Presents.
Okay, that's a great idea. Yes, I think that'll work. Okay, Brittany, if that's what you really want, my boss can make that happen.
Really? What are you talking about?
Just close your eyes, everyone, and you'll see what I mean. Well, I thought I'll give Brittany what she wanted. There is no Christmas.
What are you talking about? You can't do that.
Well, I can't, but my boss can. There are no Christmas tree lights, no bells ringing, no presents under the tree, no manger, no Bethlehem. No Christmas.
Wait a minute. Where is the manger scene?
Gone.
I knew I shouldn't have eaten that last Christmas cookie. I'm having a whopper of a nightmare!
You ate the last Christmas cookie?
Yeah, I did.
Well, this isn't a nightmare. This is life without Jesus.
So, I guess we have no Christmas decorations to put away. So, I can head for home. Presents, here I come.
Hold on, Brittany. Remember, there's no Christmas. There are no presents waiting for you at home.
Terrence, you have to help us. Please change things back. Somebody pinch me. I want to wake up.
Oh, I'll pinch you. Hey, did you see that?
There's something wrong with that Christmas tree.
You're right. It has no light.
No, it's moving. The Christmas tree's moving.
What's the deal? What happened to my lights?
Hey, Jingle, I'm in the dark.
Who cares about your silly old lights? I can't ring. I'm declappered. I'm jingless, I tell you, jingless.
Oh, no. The worst thing that could happen to any present. I'm empty. Someone has taken my gift. Look, I'm just an empty box.
Who did this terrible thing? Who canceled Christmas? We need help immediately.
We want Christmas.
We can't believe it's gone. No tinsel, no garland, no Christmas carol song. We want it, we miss it, whatever can we do? Christmas, oh Christmas, we want you.
A tree that's evergreen, but now without my blinking lights, I'm sad to see.
No shining.
Christmas,
we can't believe it's gone. No tinsel, no garland, no Christmas.
gloomy tree I've become. No lights, not even one twinkle anywhere. And oh, hi, Mr. Ornament and Garland.
What can we do to help? Can we get you an aspirin?
It's a Christmas tree, Madison. It doesn't have a headache.
How sad, a Christmas tree with no blink.
Who ever heard of Christmas in the dark?
It looks kind of sad.
And it looks kind of wilted. Has anyone watered you lately?
I don't need water. I need lights. Lots and lots of lights. That's what Christmas is all about.
Don't you remember my wise man line in our Christmas play? Jesus said, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk through darkness. We'll have the light of light. We wise men fought the light to go to baby Jesus.
Yeah, I need that light. I've got to have it.
You remind us of how life is like without Jesus. No life, no light. Only darkness.
Everyone knows that Christmas trees are supposed to have lights, lots of lights to shine for Jesus. No lights out for me. I want to shine. Shine for Jesus.
And people need light too. They need light to shine for Jesus. Without Jesus, we have no life, no light, only darkness.
Jingle, jingle, it's no use. I lost my ring.
What can make a bell with its ring?
No ring-a-ling, no ting-a-ling.
What good is a bell that won't ring?
This is serious, Brittany. Look what you've done.
Don't blame me, blame him.
Yes, the ring has left us. No one is left to ring out the good news of Jesus.
But the angels were the first to tell the good news, remember? But the angels said to them, "Do not be afraid, for I bring you good news, a great joy. That'll be for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord, and this will be a sign to you. You'll find the baby wrapped in cloths and lying in the manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly hosts appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to man on whom his favor rests." Luke 2:10-14.
That's right. Jesus came to earth on Christmas to save those on whom his favor rests. But notice, on whom his favor rests. So how can we gain God's favor? Since we are sinners, we don't really deserve anything more but his anger. But God so loved us that he did find favor in us, and he sent his one and only son, Jesus, to die on the cross and come on Christmas. And anybody who believed in him would find peace with God.
Newsflash, we need help. We need to help the bell find its ring.
How sad. Without Jesus, I'm chimeless.
Without Jesus, we have no good news, no joy or happiness, only sadness.
Believe me, I love turning my chimes at Christmas, telling the world about the joy of Jesus. There's nothing like it.
I heard the bells on Christmas Day. They're all familiar carols played, and wild and sweet the words repeat of peace on earth, goodwill to men.
Jingle, 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 jingle.
Again, Brittany, without Jesus, we have no ring, no chime, no joy or good news. Only silence.
You're right, Terrence. I get it. I'm sorry, really. Come on, Terrence. Put things back the way they were. Or at least wake me up. I want Christmas too. I know I was wrong. I was just wanting my presents. Look, snap your fingers or click your heels or do whatever you need to change things back. Really, I'm sorry. December 25th would be awful without Christmas. Sorry I was just focused on presents and not on Jesus.
But you are right to want at least one present.
Really? What? That iPhone X doesn't sound that super anymore.
You need to have the gift that fits inside your heart. This is a gift that cannot be bought. In fact, it's free.
Hey, I know that gift. I remember my grandma last summer telling me about that gift. She made me memorize Ephesians 2 verse 8 to 9. For it is by grace you have been saved through faith. And this is not from yourselves. It is the gift from God, not a result of works, so that no one may boast. Is that the gift you're talking about?
Yes, and Jesus is the present. And he gives us gifts right back, his hope and his love. Jesus makes life wonderful.
Gift. I'm empty inside. You're missing your gift too, Jesus. You might think I'm pretty with ribbons and with bows. You might think I'm all wrapped up and ready now to go. But something big is missing. Your say.
mentioned that you guys were cleaning up. I'm here to help.
Mr. T? Mr. T? I thought Terrence was Mr. T.
What are you talking about, Brittany?
Yeah, are you okay? Maybe you were dreaming.
Look, the lights are back on the Christmas tree. And the bells are jingling again.
Of course.
And the presents are all wrapped back and put in place.
Yeah.
And yeah, sounds like presents inside. Mr. T, you will never believe what happened. The Christmas tree, the jingle bell, and the present was alive. It was unbelievable. The Christmas tree had no lights, the bell couldn't ring, and the present was empty.
Sounds amazing, but everything seems to be all right now, because you seem really happy.
I am so happy. I have forgotten the true meaning of Christmas. Jesus, you do know that Jesus is the reason
for the season.
Come on, everyone. Let's get these decorations put away. I'm gonna head for home.
Still want to play with the iPhone X, Brittany?
Sure, but before that, I want to read the Christmas story from the Bible with my family. Toys are great. Well, first, I want to learn more about Jesus. You know, Jesus makes Christmas wonderful, and with Jesus, I'll have a wonderful life.
Isaiah says, for to us a son is given. And he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Jesus is the reason for this season. Bring his light into your life. Let his good news ring out to all you know. And accept his free gift of love, then you will truly have a wonderful life.